He's even missing an eye. But it didn't take a month to sell, and it sold for $78 on eBay. Hey, Bolo Buddies, thanks for watching. Full-time reseller. $600 for a My Little Pony. Amazing, right?
All right, let's get started.
Hey, Bolo Buddies, thanks for watching. All right, in this video, we are going to talk about big money bolos posted by members of my Facebook group. This is my Facebook group. If you're not in it, definitely go and join. There's a link down below in my link tree. Just come follow. There's, I think, getting close to 80,000 members in that group. So it is a big group with a lot of information, a lot of bolos, and a lot of other reseller information in the post. So come check it out. Here's what I post. I posted, share your best May bolo. And then everybody in the comments puts an item, a screenshot of their item. They tell where they got it, what they paid for it, and what it sold for. And then I bring it in video format to you here. And let's get started with these big money bolos. This first one, wow. I have this bolo for these glasses called Lunar. L-U-N-O-R. I never heard of this brand, but found out they have some expensive glasses. I got them a couple weeks ago at a thrift store for $2, put them up for $400 and took a best offer of $290 since I needed some money. This one comes from Bolo Buddies member, Serene Dreams, and this is her eBay store. Definitely go check her out. If I pop up a screen share of a member, a Bolo Buddies member, that means they have joined my channel for perks, level 2 and up. There is a link down below with more information on that. If you're interested, awesome. If not, no worries. My channel is completely free. Memberships are for perks, but I will link them in the description of the video. So their eBay stores, YouTube channels will be down there. Definitely check them out. They are Bolo Finders. And they are long octagon shape. Frame with lenses. The next item comes from Bolo Buddies member eBay store right here. It is Katie's Corner 1203. And she said, I bought a bag of American Girl clothes at a local thrift store, broke them into lots of matching sets, paid $2 for the whole bag, listed this set for $49, took a best offer of $42. Took about 2 weeks to sell. I have made over $250 on the bag. That is awesome. This is the American Girl doll Felicity purple traveling gown dress, shoes, book, and hanger. So one thing I will say is if you can identify which doll the outfit goes on, put that doll's name in the title. That's going to help you sell it. Bought these sandals at a thrift store for $1, sold for asking price of $70 plus shipping. Took about a week to sell. Ooh, El Artiste. Probably said that wrong. Spring Step Copa Bloom Floral Slip-On Women's Sandals. Never heard of this brand. And looks like they're a big money bolo. This also comes from Katie's Corner 1203. I paid $5 for this plush from Facebook Marketplace and sold it in about a month for the full asking price of $45 plus shipping. It was missing a tush tag, but it still sold. Yes, just say it's missing the tush tag or tag. I don't know if everybody uses the word tush tag or if that's a reseller term. Let me know down in the comments. It is a Walden Wow Wow Wubsy plush Nick Jr. Nanco Fisher stuffed animal. And this is what it looks like. Vintage Native American Navajo Art Pottery Angel Girl Figurine Clay and Chalk. This beautiful figurine was found at a Southern Ohio Goodwill for $3.89 plus tax. When I seen her, I could hear Crazy Lamp Lady say, isn't she just darling? It sold within a month after sending an offer for $39.99. Buyer paid shipping. This Navajo Angel went back home to New Mexico after spending some time in Ohio. And this is what it looks like. This was sourced from a Goodwill. This 5.5-inch vase was marked for $3.89 plus tax. Google Lens said Legrasse, L-E-G-R-A-S, Legrasse. And then I was able to further verify it through a glass identification group where I was supplied the catalog information for it. Antique Legrasse French Art Glass Spatter Glass Vase 3668, 1898, end of day glass. The quality of the glass and the color stood out on the shelf. It was delicate and breathtaking, to be honest. I listed it for $49.99 and sent out an offer for $44.99 with the buyer's paying shipping. Selling on eBay is fun and financially rewarding, but selling beautiful items is fulfilling. And this is what it looks like. Paid $1.06 at the Goodwill, 50 plus shipping is what it sold for, and it sold in 12 hours. Everybody loves a good, quick bolo, right? Vintage 1997, original Tiger Skip It Yellow skipping jumping toy. That's what it looks like. Anybody ever seen one of those? This one comes from Bolo Buddies member, Thrifter Picker Shipper, and this is her eBay store. She said, "One of my lifelong friends passed away 2 years ago, now of cancer. I actually inherited everything she owned as her family had all passed away prior and she had never married. Unfortunately, she was a bit of a hoarder of nice things. This 4-carat garnet 14-carat gold ring was in her tons of jewelry, so I got it free and sold it for $425. This is what it looks like. It is an F-E-E-F-F-Y, I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, BH 14-carat garnet ring, 4 carats, vintage size 9, cushion cut signed. How beautiful is that? This one comes from Bolo Buddies member, Basket Case Mama's Fab Finds. It is a plush. I love plush. This was a surprise. Found him in a bag of plush from a local Goodwill. Cost was about 53 cents per item in the bag. This cute little French Bulldog by Carter's is a Bolo. Listed him for 70 based on comps. He is small, a baby toy size, and accepted an offer for 50 from a very grateful and excited buyer. Woohoo, YouTube and eBay, Basket Case Mama Fab Finds. Check her out, and I will link her down below. This one also comes from a Bolo Buddies member. This one is from Piece of Scrap, and this is her YouTube. She said, paid $3 at the Goodwill, accepted a best offer of 52 shipped. So I think, I see here. So it looks like she took a best offer and the total was $52. Disney Crown Crafts Classic Winnie the Pooh Fringe Throw Afghan Blanket Baby. And this is what it looks like. Found this at the Goodwill for $7.99. It is a Squishmallow. It is Brooke the Polar Bear. And this one was found by Toy Attic. And this is her YouTube channel. Definitely go and subscribe to her. She talks a lot about different toys, vintage toys, a lot about like strawberry shortcake and some of the older things that you guys may not know about. So definitely sub her up for that type of content. And she's a Bolo finder, by the way. I found these Adidas Predator cleats at my local thrift store for $4.99, cleaned them up and listed on a 7-day eBay auction and sold for $130 plus shipping. Oh, it doesn't say plus shipping. I just made that up. $130. I don't know if they paid shipping or not. This one comes from Nina's Jewels. She's a Bolo Buddies member also. Her YouTube and eBay are both Nina's Jewels. We picked up this vintage Made in West Germany crab tree and Evelyn brush in its original box at an estate sale for $2. It appeared unused. It sold in a few months later for our asking price of $79.99 and they do free shipping. I went to my little local flea market, normally less than 10 vendors, paid $3 for the set. Don't sleep on survivalist books. Foxfire is a 12 book series and the group puts out other books. Buyer paid full price. Looks like they sold for $100 and they paid $3 for them. Never heard of this. Foxfire, survival, self-sufficient. Huh, this is what they look like. This one here, got these maps out of one of the storage units I bought in January or February. So I'm fully into profit at this point. Old maps do great. Second picture included because they weren't in great condition and still sold for $70. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration put out maps, track weather and oceans. Most people know them as that's who watch storms, tornadoes, and hurricanes. Oh, wow. Interesting Bolo right there. Would you guys have picked it up or walked past it? Let me know down in the comments. And then she also included this photo. This one was a freebie. Helped my mother-in-law, now ex, move in 2010. She gave me her dishes. Used them until I replaced them and put them in a box for my son. Got a divorce, left my dishes with the ex, and pulled these back out. Decided to look up what they might be worth a few weeks ago and decided to list them. $102 for the set, and I still have several loose pieces. Now I'm using the cheap pieces I got from the storage units. All right. It is, oh boy, I don't know how to say this. A-R-C-O-P-A-L. Archipal? Shamatry? Oh my goodness. China dinerware, 20-piece set. Set for four, France, scalloped, floral, excellent use condition. This is what they look like. This one comes from Bolo Buddies member, the Kitschy Canson, and this is her eBay store. Bought this humidor pipe stand at an estate sale for $10. Had it listed for 2 months at $75, sent out an offer of $60, and it sold. It is a Fairfax tobacco pipe stand, and this is what it looks like. This one comes from Bolo Buddies member Abigail's Artful Abode, and that is her YouTube channel. She is fantastic. I will link her down below. She said, I had spotted these rather large ornate mirrors at the antique mall I have a booth in. It struck me as a Victorian, but could be newer. The vendor knew I liked it, so when I was in there the last time, she offered it to me for $35. It only took a week, and it sold for $225 on Etsy to someone who follows my channel and Instagram. It was so stressful wrapping it and took so much bubble wrap, but it was well worth the hassle. I was going to say, oh my goodness, shipping a mirror would be terrifying. I'm guessing she probably double boxed it, but I don't know. Here's another one from Abigail's Artful Abode. This is not my usual genre. I love her. She put in parentheses J-O-H-N-R-U-H for me, just in case I didn't know how to say it. And I did. I saw it and I'm like, I know that's not pronounced how it looks. That is awesome. Thank you so much. But I knew that one. I remembered. But yeah, if I wouldn't have, that would have been fantastic. I'm like, I feel like my face got a little red on that. That's awesome. You guys are awesome. Thanks for understanding that I can't pronounce things. Okay, so she said, but it reminded me of when I was a teenager and loved my aluminum skateboard I rode everywhere. I picked this up when I was in Portland last December at a garage sale for $10, and it just sold on Etsy. Luckily, I had an odd-sized box that was perfect and was thrilled that my instinct was on target. Someone like me probably bought it because it is nostalgic. It looks like it sold for $95 on Etsy. One more from Abigail's Artful Abode. She said, this paper mache kitty is in the worst for wear. So not good condition, but very old, probably the 40s. And originally he would have held candy. I won it in an online auction for $26, but was starting to have doubts because of condition. He's even missing an eye, but it didn't take a month to sell. And it sold for $78 on eBay. Just goes to show, yeah, those old candy containers can do awesome, especially like Christmas and Halloween. Look them up. Speaking of Halloween, I bought this vintage Annalie pumpkin at a garage sale for $3. Not knowing anything about this brand, the person having the sale encouraged me to buy it. Of course they did. After I told her I was an eBay seller, she told me it would sell for big money. I listed it on eBay and Mercari for $89. After 2 weeks, I took a best offer on Mercari for $65. Needless to say, I was very happy. So you gotta wonder, the person at the garage sale, like, if they knew the value, why didn't they sell it on eBay or Mercari? It's crazy when people at garage sales know the value and they still sell it for $3. Pretty awesome. Bought these at a local thrift store to help the homeless in our area, Orlando. I knew the design was great, and the butterflies. Bought them for $6. Discovered they are 1970s Tony Lama butterfly boots. After leather cleaning them, I cross-listed for $200, and after 12 hours, they sold for full amount on Poshmark. Great flip. Hope the buyer loves them. There you go. Those are cool. They look like butterfly wings. Got this War Baby 3 book from a personal collection clean out, sort of an estate sale, where they wanted $1 per book. This sold for full price within 24 hours of listing of $220, and it looks like the buyer paid shipping. purchased this utensil set at a local thrift store for $14 and change. I didn't know how valuable they were at the time. I just knew I had not seen this brand name on utensils. Sorry, you guys, I'm reading straight from from the Facebook group. So if there's like a typo, it catches me off guard. So that's what's happening there. And we all have typos when we type, so it's just hard to read sometimes. So I apologize. Once I got to the parking lot, I had to look them up. And well, they were worth the $14. I posted them on eBay for $1,100 or best offer. And within a week, I got an offer of $500 that I gladly took. So priced it high, took a best offer of $500 in a week. I'm going to guess that they probably could have held out for more based on what they listed it for and what it sold for. But wow, wow, wow. They are Calvin Klein stainless steel utensils, 6 complete sets and a total of 46 pieces. This is what it looks like. Red cast iron koi fish hanging tea light candle holder. I found this at the Goodwill for $5.99. I knew immediately it was a Bolo, but when I picked it up to put it in my cart, I almost put it back. It was heavy, nearly 7 pounds. Sure enough, there were sold comps as high as $69. So I listed my Rusty Beauty for $69.99 and in less than a week later accepted an offer of $55 plus shipping. I probably could have waited and got more, but it's been slow and I only have $5.99 into it. I am very happy. Yep. I agree. You know, when things are slow, you're more likely to accept offers. Let me know in the comments, who does not accept offers on eBay? Who does not have that best offer option? And how do you guys do? I would say the majority of my items sell with best offer. And if not, it's when I'm running a sale. So let me know. I'd love to see what you guys have to say about that. Found 6 boxes of these VeggieTales Christmas cards at the Goodwill for $2.75 each. Noticed there were extras in each box and put this lot together. Sold in less than 6 hours for $50. Was pleasantly surprised, considering only one was listed and none sold at the time. And this is what it looks like. This Bolo comes from the Bulldog Shop, and she is a Bolo Buddies member, and here is her eBay store. Sold on eBay within days of listing to someone in France for $350 plus shipping. I am selling several items for a neighbor on consignment at a 50-50 split after fees, so I had no purchase cost. Wow. It is a vintage Randell handmade knife sheath, Cognac brown leather with whetstone. I don't know. That's what it looks like. That's big money. I never would have guessed. This is even more of one that I probably walked right past. Wow. These placemats were mine. I haven't used them in a long time. So I put them up for sale on eBay. Took 4 months to sell. Accepted a best offer of $153 plus shipping for placemats. It says, oh, so small. Gula Sweetgrass 10-inch round placemat, set of 4, vintage South Carolina charger trivet. This is what they look like. This one comes from Childhood Finds, and this is her YouTube channel. And she said, I found this at an estate sale for $10 and took an offer of $92. Zippos can be big money, and this one was still sitting there at the tail end of a weekend-long sale. It is a Marlboro Zippo lighter, and it's made in the USA, untested, sold for $92 plus shipping. Got free from a family member, put it up on auction for $80 and took an offer for $80 plus shipping on the 4th day. It had lots of watchers, but no bids. It's a Disneyland Resort black and gold Sleeping Beauties something. I can't read it. Castle maybe? And this is what it looks like. That is awesome. Purchased on Whatnot. Cost of goods came out to $4 plus shipping, sold in about a week on eBay for $40 plus shipping. It is a Maz 15 Exitos LP Latin Teljano Tex-Mex vinyl record. Wow, that is fantastic. 4 into 40, and she got it on Whatnot. I'm telling you guys, if you're not sourcing on Whatnot, it's definitely a place that you can source. I'm also selling on Whatnot. If you guys want to go down below, I do have a link where you can join Whatnot and get $15 to shop. That is my referral link. So definitely check it out and get that free money. This next one comes from Got Junk in Our Trunk, who is a Bolo Buddies member. And that is her YouTube channel. She is also a moderator of this group. So please go show her some love and thank her for helping out with the Facebook group. Purchase from Facebook Marketplace for $5, sold for a best offer of 50 plus shipping within 48 hours. It is a Jeff Dunham Talking Peanut Doll Green Shoe. Green shoe? Stuffed plush, and it works. And this is what it looks like. This is also from Got Junk in Our Trunk. Purchased a dozen of these type gaming magazine centerfolds, different characters for a total of $2 from a friend who is downsizing his eBay store. Three have sold this month for full or near asking price plus shipping. Vintage War of the Monsters folded insert promo poster, 13 by 22, $18.99 plus shipping. Here is another one. And Got Junk in Our Trunk has a video on this. She sells little golden books of all ages and condition. Will sell to a collector. This was purchased at a yard sale for 10 cents. Was animal chewed and written in, but it is a harder to find title. Sold for full asking price of $19.99 plus shipping. And look at the condition of this. Is that unbelievable or what? Sold this piece. There were two at a yard sale. I paid $1 for each of them. Just sold for $130. Took a best offer. She is about 5 inches tall. It is a Hoggenzauer women golfer cast bronze figure. And this is what it looks like. And yeah, it's a figurine. All right, you guys, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Check out the Facebook group if you haven't already. I would love to see your June BOLO if you want to share it, and I will feature it in a video just like this. Thank you guys so much for being here, and thanks for watching. I got them at a couple...